Hello everyone, so I am live with another new video and let's get started. So you can now follow me on Instagram. I put different practice MCQs in stories there. So go on Instagram, follow me and do practice them. One such session was yesterday where I put different MCQs of parasympathetic system and many people gave the wrong answer. So I have decided to make a short explanatory video on it. So let's go. So this was the first question. So how parasympathetic system will act on heart? So here acetylcholine will bind to its muscarinic receptor M2 and here it will give inhibitory effect. So it will decrease heart rate, it will decrease AV conduction. So ultimately there will be bradycardia. So the answer is that it depresses the heart. So in bronchus, there is M3 receptor present. So its stimulation will cause bronchoconstriction and that's why anticholinergic drug will lead to bronchodilation. In case of gastrointestinal tract, there are mainly two muscarinic receptors present, M1 and M3. So with the help of these receptors, secretion of hydrochloric acid is stimulated and so there is increased risk of peptic ulcer disease. And if we talk about peristalsis, so it's increased and sphincters will be relaxed. And that's why anticholinergic drugs are used as spasmolytic agents. So muscarinic receptors present in eye are M3. So cholinergic system will stimulate the circular muscle of the eye, which is sphincter pupillae, and ultimately it will result into meiosis. There is also contraction of ciliary muscle of the eye, and so accommodation is possible, and that's why anticholinergic drugs will result into mydriasis. So in case of urinary bladder, there is M3 receptor present. So different cholinergic drugs will stimulate the detrusor muscle and relax the trigone. So ultimately, it will result in increased micturition. And that's why we use anticholinergic drugs that will result in urinary retention. So M3 receptor is present on different glands. And that's why their stimulation will result in increased secretion. And that's why increased salivation, increased lacrimation, as well as sweating will also be increased. And on the other hand, anticholinergic drugs are present, so that will result in dry mouth, dry eyes, and difficulty in swallowing. And that's why the main adverse effect of atropine is dry mouth. So thank you so much for completing the video. If you like this content, then give this video a like and also subscribe to the channel.